In the last 3 months, there's so many people who quit their job or they were fired or no job to work to do because of the crisis that we have now. And many people want to come back to the land, want to grow their own food, want to be independent on themselves in a piece of land. But to have a piece of land is not easy for many people. I understand this very well because I had this experience before. When I quit my job and I left Bangkok many years ago, I feel desperate. I feel hopeless in the beginning that how can I live? What can I do if I have to go back to the village? There's no job in the village. What can I do? How can I make income? And if I want to have a land, how can I have a piece of land when I have no money? So this is a big question that tortured me for a long time. But I need to leave the city at that time because I don't think city is good for human, but it's good for a robot. So I went back home. I want to have a piece of land, but I don't have anything. No land, no money in my hand. What I did is I borrowed the land from my mother. But she don't want to let me use a lot of her land because she grow rice already. At the end, she gave me only 200 square feet only. It's not very big piece of land. It's 200 square feet. It's the size of a building, a small building. But from this small piece of land, I can make enough money to buy another piece of land later, 3 years later. So this is my experience that I want to share for many people who want to have a land, to want to live on the land, but has no money, no land. I want to share my experience. Maybe it may be useful for you, for anybody, especially people who live in tropical area. This is quite easy way to get money to buy a piece of land. So from my experience, I borrowed my mother's land, 200 square feet in the beginning. But I think now many country, many area, many people have land, but they don't use it. It's not hard. It's not too hard to ask to use somebody's land to work on it. If you love to live like this, if you love to do gardening, it will be a good way to make money. But we cannot make farming like normal farmer. We need to do it differently. I will share my experience. When I got a piece of land, it's not very big. 200 square meters is nothing compared to normal land. So the first thing is I check around the village. What do people eat in the village? What kind of vegetable that people eat in that village? In the past, what kind of vegetable did they eat? I collect all of them. And then I bring it back to my small area. So the first thing is I know that people love papaya. I grow papaya. Only 5 of them. Papaya. 5 papayas only. Don't grow more than that. It's too much work. And then after that, I know that people eat chilies and eggplants every day. So between papaya, I have chili and eggplant. Chili and eggplant, any of them is 5. And when people eat lime, I have 2 lime trees at the end like this. After that, we have some basil. Many kind of basil on this way. And then we have a long bed. The long bed, if we grow, we need to think about vegetables that we can harvest them often. Grow one time and harvest very often. For example, like Chinese chive or garlic chive. In Asian country, we eat a lot of chive. So we have Chinese chive here. So I plant the long bed of chive, but I cut them 1 meter per day. I cut the chive. So the first day I cut them from here, the second day, the third day, until the 10th. And then this part, they grow back again. So this part, I can harvest every day. I can make income every day from this bed. The second bed. The second bed, I grow morning glories. Morning glory is a kind of vegetable that grow very fast and then never die. So I plant morning glory one time and I harvest every day for more than 1 year. I did the same thing, 1 meter per day. So these 2 beds, I make money every day. And the third bed is spring onion, or some people call green onion. Spring onion is split off itself. When you plant them in the ground, after a few weeks, when they grow very well, they start to split. One spring onion, only 1 week, they split off into 2. And if you wait another week, they split off into 3. So they split off every week. I harvest them the same, 1 meter per day. The first day, I harvest from this one. The second day, the third day, and then after I came to the end of the bed, this side starts to split up again. They multiply very quick. So this 3 bed, we grow one time, and it lasts more than 1 year. And I can harvest them more than 1 year, every day. This is the way I design my garden. And the rest of the bed, I grow many things. So this bed, only 1 bed, I grow more than 10. The first row, I grow coriander. The second row, I have Chinese kale. The third row, I have dill. The fourth row, I have cabbages. And then I split half. So I grow another 5 varieties, another 4 varieties this way. So this bed, we have more than 10 varieties already. And another bed, we do the same thing. So we have many varieties of vegetables in this garden. And along the side, I have a lot of galanga, 5 galanga, and then 5 lemongrass, and then beans, long beans, and cucumber. So I try to use every square foot on 200 square meters to make it to make income from it. So when I design the garden like this, the whole garden, I take care of them only water the whole garden only 15 minutes per day. I use showering can, scoop water in the pond and walk. 15 minutes, I finish watering by hand. And then every day, I maybe spend every week I will spend 1 hour per day, per week, to pull out water hyacinth from the pond and then collecting the straw to make compost. I make compost once a week. In my village, they have a lot of cows. In the morning, villagers then open the cage of the cows. So all the cows will walk out of the village to the rice field. Every morning, before they get out of the rice field, they will poop on the road everywhere. So people feel disgusting about cow's poop. They think it smells not very nice and look yucky. So I collect them. I start collect cow poops and then bring it back to make the compost. The first layer is straw. The second layer is cow poop. And the next layer is water hyacinth. Straw, cow poop, water hyacinth. Or sometimes I have leaves from the trees, mango leaves or any kind of leaves. But if we use only straw, water hyacinth and cow dung, 18 days it turned to black soil, turned to very good compost. But if we use leaves from the big trees, it takes 3 months to decompost in tropical country. So I have a lot of compost pile for my small garden. In this small area, I have more than 50 varieties of vegetable in this small area. So every day, I water once a day, one time a day. And after 3 months, I can see the big change in my family. After 3 months, my mother, she had to go to work and make some amount of money to save it to buy food for 6 people in the family. But when I start this garden 3 months, my mother deposit money every month after that. Because the money that she saved to buy food, she did not buy any food. Because the vegetable in the garden is nicer and better from the market. And we have more variety than in the market. So my mother started to have income without working more. And then what I learned next is 6 people eat from this garden. We cannot eat all of them. For example, like a papaya, one papaya tree, there's a lot of papaya. We cannot eat all of them. Chilies, eggplant, we cannot eat all of them. So I have to pick them up, collect them every day. Whatever look good, pick them and sell them in the market. The first time I think about how can I make money in the village? Because villagers has no money. Villagers have no job for me. How can I make income? But when I start the garden, I noticed that farmers start to come to my farm and they want to buy vegetable from me. The first time I just give them for free. But later on, when they come often, they feel ashamed to get free every day. So they offer to give money. And after that, we still have leftover. So I bring it to the market every day. In the market, I never go get to the market. Just halfway, I sold everything out very quick. So every day, I make income from this bed. The Chinese chive, I cut it
1 meter from this area,
and then I turned it into pickle vegetable or fermenting
vegetable. So I make only this area.
The income I got is the same with minimum wage that people work 8 hours per day in the city from this area.
And in this area, I got another amount of money. And this area, I got more. So this 3 bed,
I make more than minimum wage in the city already.
But I did not have only 3 beds. All everything here,
I bring to the market. But each of them, I don't have a lot. I did not have a lot of them.
Like a chili,
I maybe have a handful of chilies per day, but I can make money from it. Or eggplant, I maybe have 5 or 10 eggplant per day.
So I have more than 20 variety of vegetable put on the cart and walk to the village every day.
So people in the village, they're waiting for me every day. Because if they go to the normal market, there are less than 5 variety of vegetable, wilted vegetable in the market. And then they don't know what kind of chemical in there. But everybody know that my garden has no chemical. When I push the cart to the village, people just come to my cart. 5 minutes, I sold out most of them. Because if you come late, you miss all the vegetable that I have. Each kind of vegetable I have, maybe 5 bunch or 10 bunch or maybe 3 bunch, some of them. So not a lot. So if you fast, you get more. If you slow, you do not get anything. So that's the way I make money every day from this garden. So every square inch in this garden, I can turn into income every day. So more than 50 varieties of vegetable in here is more than they have, the vegetable that they have in the market. So it's more interesting. So what I learned from this garden is,
when I do a small garden, I can take care of them very well. I can make enough compost to make them grow fast. For example, like this 3 bed, I grow only 1 time. If they grow slow, I cover with compost. Morning glory, if they grow slow or the shoot not big enough, not look nice, cover with compost. The next few days, the new shoot come up is bigger. So the same thing. So to have compost is very helpful to make income in this way. So what I learned is, if we make small garden, we make more money. If we make a big farm, we make less money. This is against the belief of people. Because people think if you make more, you will get more. But it doesn't work like that with farming. Farming, if you work more, you have to invest more money. When you invest more money, it's very hard to get money back. Like I grow 5 chilies plant here. I grow 5 chilies plant. I make more money than my cousin who grow 10 acres of chilies. Because I grow 5 chilies plant, I did not put any money on it. I just use my labor. I work with hand. And I sell it every day. I make income every day. Not a lot, but I make it every day. And when every money that I got is total profit, because I did not invest money. But my cousin who saw me sell chilies, very good price, and he plant chili for 10 acres. But he cannot grow himself, so he need to hire a tractor to plow the land. After that, he don't have enough chili seed to plant. He need to buy chili seed from the market. But after he plant the seedling in a small plot, and when they grow big enough like this, he pull them out and he need to transplant them again in 10 acres. He cannot do it himself, so he has to hire people to plant them. When people start to plant them, he cannot use watering can to water by hand like me. So he has to buy pump by pipe, by the water system, sprinkler system, to water. This costs a lot of money. And then after water, they did not grow well. He cannot make compost like me. He has to buy chemical fertilizer from the market to put on it. It costs a lot of money too. When the chili plant, any vegetable, if you use chemical fertilizer, they grow fast, but so weak. The pest attack. He cannot control the pest. He have to use chemical to kill them. Until the chili ripe, all 10 acres look red, the whole thing. He cannot pick chili himself. He need to hire people to pick the chili. And then when he got a lot of chili, he cannot put on the cart and walk to the market like me because it's so many baskets of chilies. He has to hire the truck to bring the chili to the city. And the people in the city said, too many chilies, how can I buy the normal price? Because I don't know where to sell it. So they put the price down. So he have to sell cheaper than I can sell. So if we calculate how much money he invests in that chili, that's a lot of money. Even he sell all of them, at the end, he lost money. This is what happened with farming. So I learned that when we use labor, when we use energy in farming, we will get more energy, get more money, more food. But when we use money in farming, we will lose our energy, lose money, lose our food, because it will not be like this. So when people grow chili 10 acres, they don't eat chilies 3 times a day. They want to eat kale, they want to eat papaya, they want to eat luffa, they want to eat morning glory, but they need to buy it. But I did not buy anything. So that's the difference. So what I learned is when we use energy, we get more energy. You feel strong, you feel healthy because you exercise. And then how much you sell it, that's the total, the profit. All of them is profit because we did not invest money. So by this way, I worked in the garden for a few months, and after that I saved enough money to buy, to pay for digging a pond. I asked my mother to dig another pond here. The first time my mother said, oh, don't dig the pond, you invest your land to grow rice. I told my mother that rice is so cheap and you need to work a lot to grow rice, but pond is easier. And she allowed me to dig a pond here. So after that, I put a tiny shrimp, a snail, and fish that eat grass in the pond. And after that, I cut the grass, I'll put some straw or banana leaf, I cut them, and put on the edge of the pond. The fish come and eat them. I did not invest money in fish at all, but I can catch fish sell every day. So this, the 200 square meters gardening and another 200 square meters pond, these two places make money for me every day. I can deposit money every day. And only 3.5 years, I save enough money from this small place to buy another piece of land, 9 acres of land in northern of Thailand, in Chiang Mai, that where we start Phan Phan now. So this is my experience that I did. I solved my problem. When I want to have a piece of land, but I have no money, no land, how can I start it? This is one choice that I want to share with other people. If you look at your area, if you love gardening, this choice is quite easy and good, because I work less than 1 hour per day to take care of this part and make more income than minimum wage 3 times from this design. And then don't think about to grow cash crop, and then don't think about to sell in the big supermarket. It's too complicated. It's too hard. You get less. The best market is in the village. If you live in the village, wherever there are people, that is the market. So don't sell it very far. If you sell around yourself, no packaging, no transportation cost, you decrease a lot. If you sell very cheap, cheaper than chemical vegetable, you still make more money than normal people. So this is the way I want to tell people who quit their job, who feel like they want to come back to the land, but no money, no land. I think you can borrow somebody's land and start something like this. This is one choice for them. But you need to love gardening. If you love it, you can do something like this. It will not hard. It will be fun and fun and fun. So this garden changed my life completely. I never think that I want to go back to work in the city anymore. Many people offer me a lot of job after that, but I refuse all of them. I said, when I want a job, when I was in Bangkok, I want a job. Nobody, I cannot get a job. But when I don't want a job, a lot of people offer me jobs. So I don't want it anymore because this is a lot easier for me to live like this. 1 hour per day. I have enough to eat, enough to feed 6 people, and have enough income to have deposit, to have saving every day. And then I have another 11 hours free time. So I can do anything after that. So if you like gardening, you design your life like this, you will have 11 hours free time like me. And then you can do what you like with 11 hours per day every day. If you love to be a teacher, go be the best teacher. If you like to do business, go do business. If you like to be an artist, to be a singer, go shouting and singing and do whatever. This is the freedom. This is the meaning of life. This is the way that we enjoy our life. It's fun to think this way. So we have choice. You can choose whatever you like. Life is easy. Don't make it hard. It's not fun.